I am here to narrate to you the story of a small and accidental discovery. This discovery led to the fixation of a date of an ancient Indian battle, and that battle fixed the political boundaries of North and South India. I am talking about a copperplate inscription of the Chalukya ruler Pulakeshi II, which is held by an antiquity collector of Mumbai, namely Mr. Raghuveer Pai. And it was due to his generosity that we could get it and read it. So this is the copperplate inscription. It has got three plates in all. And the plates are really very small, 22 centimeters by 5.8 centimeters. They have a beautiful ring and a seal with a boar, that is Varaha, which was the symbol of the Chalukyas. This copperplate inscription was actually highly rusted. Now, these plates, they have in all 20 lines of matter. Only 20 lines of matter. The language is Sanskrit, and the script is the Southern Brahmi that was prevalent in 7th century. And the number of lines that the plates have is 5 plus 5 plus 6 plus 4 in all 20. Now, there are many inscriptions of this Pulakeshin and other Chalukya rulers, and their genealogy is given there. Of course, this inscription speaks about the grandfather of this Pulakeshin II, that is Pulakeshin I, then his father Kirtivarman, and Pulakeshin himself. But there are several copperplate inscriptions that we had to study in order to decipher and deduce the matter and our conclusions from this copperplate inscription. Now, this is how the plates look after they are cleaned. Now, the text of this inscription, if you analyze it, it has an opening, Mangala Charana. Then there is a genealogy of the ruler, which starts from the grandfather of the ruler. Then there is a mention of Pulakeshin's conflict with Harshavardhana, and that is the most important point here. Then, since this is a donation, there are the details of the donee, the date, and then the details of the donation given. And finally, there are the closing verses. I think you will have fun in actually reading or listening to the matter of the inscription. It's a small matter. So, Swasti, Shrimatam, Sakala Bhuvana Samstuya Mana, Manavya Sagotranam, Hariti Putranam, Sapta Loka Matruhi, Sapta Matruhi, Abhivarditanam, Kartikeya Parirakshana Prapta Kalyana Paramparanam, Bhagavan Narayana Prasadat Samasadita, Varaha Lanchana Ikshana Kshana Vashikruta Shesha Mahibhrutam, Chalikyanam, Chalikyanam Kulamalankarishnor, Ashwamedhava Bhruta Snapita Pavitri Krita Gatrasya, Satyashraya Shri Pulakeshi Vallabha Maharajasya Tanayaha, Parakrama Akranta Vanavasyadi Paranrupati Mandala Pranibadha Vishuddha Kirti Patakasya, Kirti Varma Vallabha Maharajasya Tanayo, Naya Vinayadi Guna Vibhutyashraya Satyashraya Prithivi Vallabha Maharaja Erajaha, Samara Sanghat Tormi Samsakta Shri Harshavardhana Parajayopalabdha Parameshwara Paranamadheyaha Sarvan Adnyapayati Viditamastuvaha Asmabhi Kaushika Gotraya Naga Sharmane Asya Veda Vedanga Paragasya Navame Varshe Vaishakha Purnime Chandragrahana Divase Godavari Mahanadi Tate Brahmana Vataviya Nama Grame Ch Uncha Panchashan Nivartanancha Kshatra Mahamanena Shrimata Pulakeshi Vallabha Maharadnya Vaishwadevi Satriya Yadnya Gotrina Dattam Bahuvir Vasudha Bhukta Rajavis Sagaradhibhi यस्य यस्य यदा भूमिस् तस्य तस्य तदा फलम् स्वदत्तां परदत्तां वा यो हरेत वसुंधरां षष्टि वर्ष सहस्राणि विष्ठायां जायते कृमिः. सो दैट्स द मैटर. बट व्हेन वी केम अक्रॉस द इंस्क्रिप्शन, दिस पर्टिकुलर मेंशन ऑफ द डिफीट ऑफ हर्षवर्धन एट द हैंड्स ऑफ पुलकेशिन अट्रैक्टेड आवर अटेंशन. And that is why we went into a deep inquiry into this. Now the first question was as to where these villages fall, because the inscription at present is in Mumbai and it was purchased by Mr. Pai from Bijapur, and these are places far away, and the inscription says that it was given on the banks of the Godavari River. And the name of the village given is Vataviya or Brahmana Vataviya. So then around Godavari, one has to find what are the villages that match with the name Vataviya. And the first name that comes into mind is Vadgaon. And if you see, there are so many Vadgaons. So without any suffix, mere Vadgaon. So there is one in Nasik district, one in Ahmednagar, two in Aurangabad, one in Parbhani and three in Nanded. We have not gone into Telangana and further. And Vadgaon with various suffixes like Vadgaon Dhairi, Vadgaon Sheri, Vadgaon Mawal, etc. So there are 8 Vadgaons in Nasik, 11 in Ahmednagar, 4 in Aurangabad, 11 in Bid, and 9 in Parbhani. And actually, you cannot really ascertain that out of these scores of villages, which village must have been donated. But through a very close look at the topo sheets that were created by the Survey of India, we found that near Paithan, there is a village named Vadoli or Vadwali, and nearby that, there is also a village named Brahmangao. So perhaps this is the Brahmana Vataviya. And it is Godavari Mahanadi Tate. So perhaps this is the village, and that is why we fixed this village as the village that is donated. Now why that? Because this battle between Harshavardhana and Pulakeshin was fought on Narmada, and this part of the country actually it falls on the route that comes from Narmada to the south. So Badami was the capital of the Chalukyas, and then Paithan and the areas around, they certainly fall on this track which comes from Narmada to Badami. So there is every chance that Pulakeshin was camping there, and since it was a holy day of a lunar eclipse, he donated this village there. Now the second point was to fix the date, and it is not merely fixing the date of this particular inscription, but it is also a matter of fixing the date of this particular battle, which is so important and around which so many events in the history of India in 7th century are woven. And it is very clearly mentioned that the 9th year of the king, that is the 9th regnal year, and Vaishakha Purnima and Chandra Grahana, so lunar eclipse. Now, if Pulakeshin's reign is fixed, only then the 9th year can be ascertained well. But that is not fixed actually. Some historians believe that it is 609, some believe that it is 610, and some believe that it is 611. And if you find the record of the lunar eclipses, that's also puzzling, because consecutively 3 years you have lunar eclipses on Vaishakha Purnima. So it's on 26th of April 617, 15th of April 618, and 4th of April 619, all are Vaishakha Purnimas and all have eclipses. And then this is the problem. But then there are other plates of the same ruler, and we could actually get some benefit from them. There is a copper plate inscription of the same ruler which was found at Kopparam, and which dates 21st year Kartika Mahanavami and Brihaspati Vasara. and that matches with October the 10th, 631, Thursday. So that means that the first year must have started somewhere in 610 and not 609 or 611. Similarly, there is a Hyderabad copper plate inscription of the third regnal year, which has a very fixed point, Bhadrapada Amavasya and solar eclipse. And this matches, this solar eclipse, it matches with Bhadrapada Amavasya, and the date is July the 23rd, 613. And now again, it comes to again 610. So, there is also another inscription by the younger brother of this Pulakeshin, and it is of the 8th regnal year, Kartika Purnima, and though it doesn't mention the lunar eclipse, there was a lunar eclipse on that day. And then the date comes to be 9th of October 618. And none of these plates have the mention of this defeat of Harshavardhana at the hands of Pulakeshin. So that means that up to 618, October 618, Harshavardhana, a mighty ruler, was not defeated by Pulakeshin. And this plate of 619, it mentions it, 9th regnal year. That means that the date should go into 619. And that is why these two dates, these two Vaishakha Purnimas of 617 and 618 cannot form the date of this inscription. And that is why we could fix the date of this inscription as Vaishakha Purnima, 9th regnal year, that is Wednesday, 4th of April 619, and which amounts to the fact that the battle between Pulakeshin and Harshavardhana, it must have taken place some months prior to this inscription, because Pulakeshin must have taken some time to travel from Narmada to Paithan. And there is also a mention in another stone inscription of Pulakeshin, which is the very famous stone inscription at Aihole, which mentions that Pulakeshin tried to actually enter Harshavardhana's territories in the north, and he could not do that. And Harshavardhana, who was actually defeated already, so he could not also enter the south. And there was a kind of truce which between them, which lasted for not only for during their careers, but also after them for centuries together. So that means that this great battle, which was a focal point of Indian history of 7th century, and there are so many events interwoven around that. This battle was fought in the winter of the year 618 and 619. The frame of the battle, or the time that was thought, was somewhere between 610 and 634. And 24 years is no bracket, actually, you know, for any battle. And we could bring it down to 4 months, because this 618 inscription, it doesn't mention the battle, and the 619 battle, it mentions the this inscription mentions the battle. That means it must have taken place in between these two actually inscriptions. So what was altogether the result of this discovery is that this is the first-hand genuine reference to Pulakeshin's victory, who was relatively a small ruler over a mighty ruler like Harshavardhana, who was ruling almost most of the parts of North India, and he used to call himself as Uttarapathapati. Now, this also throws new light on the political affairs around this inscription. And since Pulakeshin's inauguration, his coronation was also not fixed. It was either 609 or 610 or 611. It could be fixed very well as 610. And in the discovery of any charter, actually, the least benefit that is there is to find a new charter, to find a new dhoni, and to find a new village that's already there in the discovery. So this is how the discovery is. If you talk about inscriptions, there are about 85,000 inscriptions known. 85,000 inscriptions known. We don't know how many are unknown yet. Even half of them are not published till date. So there are at least 50,000 inscriptions that are waiting publication. it's a clear history that we need to bring out. And so I appeal you to actually study these subjects. Thank you.